Hi everyone, so the topic that we are going to start today is physical and chemical changes. If you just observe the following images, can you find any similarity in these images? Well, we have different images given here. The only similarity in these images is that there is a change occurring in all of them. Right, the growth of a plant, ripening of bananas, like milk being set into curd, cooking of potatoes, shortening of candles while burning, water changing into ice, these all are the examples of changes. Well, these changes can happen in a few minutes, few hours, days, months or years. So let us discuss about the changes around us. So in this chapter we'll be discussing about physical and chemical changes. What are physical changes? Physical change is a change which occurs when there is an alteration in the physical properties of a substance, for example color, density, shape, size and volume. These are some of the physical properties. The physical change does not result in the formation of any new substance, but can change the shape and size of the existing substance. For example, when an ice melts, it changes into water. See here, no new substance is formed. There is a change only in the shape and state, right? So therefore, we can call it as a physical change. Another example, we can take cutting of paper, melting of ice cream, stretching of rubber. So these are some of the examples of physical changes where no new substances formed, only physical properties are being changed, and most of the physical changes, they are reversible. So there are certain characteristics of physical changes, like only some of the physical properties such as size, shape, color and state change. During a physical change, no new substance is formed. Generally, a physical change is reversible. Generally, no overall change in energy takes place. And most important, the chemical composition of a substance remains the same during a physical change. If we talk about chemical changes, so what are chemical changes? These are the changes in which one or new substances are formed with entirely different chemical composition and properties from the original substances are formed. So when a new substance possessing different properties is formed after a change, it is called as chemical change. For example, when a cake is baked, a change occurs in its composition and a new substance is formed. Therefore, it is a chemical change. There are many more examples: ripening of fruits, burning of paper, burning of magnesium ribbon, cooking of food, rusting of iron. These are some of the examples of chemical change. So most of the chemical changes, they are irreversible, or you can say they are permanent. Here there is an example of chemical changes, and let's see what happened in this chemical change. Let us take a test tube in which we have added a copper sulfate solution about a teaspoonful, and add a few drops of sulfuric acid and water. If we just dissolve it and we just shake the solution, and after that keep iron nails into the test tube, right? After 30 minutes or after around half an hour, we'll see that the blue color of copper sulfate solution changes into light green color, and brown deposit is formed on the iron nail. Now, how does it happen? These changes are due to the chemical reaction which takes place between copper sulfate solution and iron nail. So when they both combine, they produce two new substances. They produce iron sulfate and copper, and this copper is brown in color, and this copper is brown deposit which deposits over the iron nail. So we can conclude that the composition of substance taking place get changed, new substances are formed, and this change is irreversible, and there is a change in color also. So chemical change, as in the previous activity, in this activity we have just seen that new substance is formed along with the different chemical properties. Now the chemical change is also, these chemical changes, they are also called as chemical reaction. What are chemical reactions? Chemical reaction, it is a process by which one or more substances transform into new substances having entirely different properties from the original substances is called as chemical reaction. Thus, a chemical reaction occurs during a chemical change. For example, if A plus B gives you C product, in this chemical reaction, A and B, they act as a reactant. That means the substance which react with each other to form a new substances, they are called as reactants. And the new product which is forming, new substance which is forming after a chemical change is called as product. Now here are some of the characteristics of chemical changes. What are the characters? One or more new substances are formed. These changes are generally permanent. There's a change in the physical state, evolution of gas, changes in color and smell, formation of a precipitate, and change in energy. So let us discuss about all this. First is change in physical state. Now what happened in change in physical state? As we know, there are mainly three states of matter, solid, liquid and gases. So whenever a substance undergoing chemical changes, there may be change in the state, physical state of a substance. For example, if hydrogen burns in oxygen, they will combine to form water, which is a liquid. Hydrogen and oxygen, they both are in gaseous state. When they combine, they form water, which is in a liquid state. Another character is evolution of gas. Evolution of gas means whenever two substances they combine, whenever two reactants are combining, they form product. Along with that, there is release of gas also takes place. For example, when calcium carbonate reacts with dilute hydrochloric acid, calcium chloride is being formed along with the evolution of carbon dioxide gas. Next is change in color and smell. Change in color, as I told you, when two reactants combine, new product will form, and along with that there's a change in color and smell. So there are, for example, if you heat up copper carbonate, which is green in color, if we heat it up strongly, we'll see a black residue of copper oxide is left along with the evolution of carbon dioxide gas. Next is change in energy. Now change in energy also takes place in all the chemical reactions, and during a chemical reaction, an energy either is absorbed or it is released. So The reaction in which energy is released are called as exothermic reaction, and the reaction in which energy is being absorbed, they are called as endothermic reaction. So here you can see the difference in endothermic and exothermic reactions. So this is first part of physical and chemical changes. Very soon part 2 of physical and chemical changes will be discussed with you. Thank you so much.